Ah! Oh my gosh! These are so hard to do episode by episode. I just want to keep watching! Hey guys, this is Alachia, and this is my review for Daredevil Season 2, Episode 8, Guilty as Sin. Oh man, this one was written by Whit Anderson and directed by Michael Uppendahl. Okay, so where do we start? Well, Stick is back, back again. Stick is back, kill the hand. All right, Stick is back, and we have the hand finally here, and the ninja assassins, and they are protecting that hole. We still don't know what's in that hole, but something. And so Stick ends up saving Daredevil and Elektra, because he's a badass and knows what needs to get done and knows how to do it. And Daredevil is getting people killed with his stupid no-kill policy, which I feel like should be null and void when it comes to deadly ninja assassins. Oh. But anyways, he's staying true and he doesn't want Elektra to kill, and it almost gets her killed. But then he and Stick end up having it out, and Stick finally tells Matt what the hell's going on, and that basically he's been chasing after this group called the Hand because they've discovered this secret of immortality, and that they're going to use this weapon called the Black Sky to destroy the world as we know it. I don't even know what it's supposed to do, but I have a feeling it has to do with the kid that was in Season 1 that Matt ended up saving, and they weren't really sure, or I can't remember. Wasn't Stick trying to kill the kid? I don't even remember. I think that maybe that was the weapon. So Matt's just sort of like, immortality, right, And then Stick isn't like, doesn't your whole belief system hinge on one guy being able to do something like that? And Matt's like, touche. But so we find out that Stick is the Chast, and he has this group of counter ninjas or warriors that are supposed to be going after the Hand, and there's just bigger things going on than this whole wrap up that, or this little small time thing that Daredevil thinks he's doing in Hell's Kitchen. And he's just sort of like, this war's coming, you guys don't even know what's happening, which in comic book world is always the case, right? Where there's always this crazy, more global, universal evil that's a threat. And, you know, it's kind of interesting how they're kind of pushing and pulling between like the micro story and the macro stories within the Daredevil universe right now. Punisher being like the micro, and then of course the Hand being the macro. And again, I think that's, that's my suspicion, is that it's going to all end up tying into what they end up doing with the Defenders, I think, because it just seems like this is so much bigger than something that only the Daredevil could handle. But we'll see, right? Because we're seeing all sorts of things. So then we get to the Punisher, and he's in court, and I still hate seeing him in court because it's just so awkward. But they get him on the stand, or actually they get a medical examiner on the stand, and they basically say that he's got extreme emotional disorder, and that he's basically, just like we said in the last episode, he's snapping over and over again. He just has this crazy emotional distress that's just making him go through this emotional and mental chaos. And so all he has to do is stick to that story and get on the stand and you know, testify to his own tragedy with his family. And yet we know somebody got to him. Someone, who could that be? Someone got to him. And so on the stand, he goes buck wild crazy. And he's like, yeah, I am the Punisher. Yeah, I'm guilty. You know, I'd kill those motherfuckers again. Which I, you know, obviously there may be some truth to that too. But yeah, he's definitely being coerced to say that. And you're just like, what on earth could someone have that Frank Castle could want that would get him to do something, right? Like, the Punisher is generally not someone who can be manipulated. And yet, someone has something that he wants so that he will cooperate. And I think that something is like information on maybe more people who killed his family or people who were involved with killing his family. That's the only thing I can think of that it could be. So, well, I mean, we'll see. And then the Elektra and Daredevil storyline. What a great love story, you know? But I don't think it's meant to be, as she is a homicidal psychopath who loves her ninja assassin job, and Daredevil will always be a conflicted Catholic vigilante justice warrior. It's so sad, right? You know, I think it's so sweet between them. Like, he's just sort of like, he sees that redemption, right? He looks at her and he's like, you can be redeemed. You know, like, I believe in you. Whatever you did yesterday, that's fine. It's what we do tomorrow that counts. And, you know, it's just that kind of whole hope, you know, that he always continues to bring into the story. It's just like, that's his whole theme, is that everyone can be redeemed. Everyone can have hope. And, you know, there's going to be the other side of the story where she's just like, you know, why are you so good? And, you know, because you're just sort of like, when you look at someone like that, you're just like, why are you so good? Like, how could you possibly be so good knowing what you know? And maybe he just doesn't know enough. I don't know. But she ends up slicing the ninja's throat, or the agent of the hand. And she's just like, do you still love me? And he's just sort of like, hang on, when I'm finished dying, then we can discuss you being a complete psychopath. Yes. And then Wilson Fisk is returned. Oh, you know, it's just so much stuff happens within Daredevil, like, that you keep forgetting about things, and then it keeps popping back up, and you're just sort of like, as soon as he got into that recess area of the prison, I was just sort of like, oh yeah. So I think Fisk has information that he wants about the people who killed his family, or maybe how he could possibly get out. I don't know. But I was really happy to see the return of Fisk. He was my favorite character in season one, and I can't wait to see. I hope we see, like, you know, how his story is going to evolve, because I have a feeling he'll be back and as more prominent in season three. So, But yes, so anyways, I'm going to go watch season nine, I wish. I'm going to go watch episode 9 now. I'm going to try to get that review out tonight as well, or at least film it, because tomorrow I'm going to go see Batman v Superman, and I want to have all that out for you guys. Okay, so, whoa, I can't wait to hear the comments about this episode. All right, thanks again for watching, and if you'd like to see more, you can click right here and watch my episode 7 review for Daredevil, or you can click right here and watch my vlog on my South by Southwest experience at the Gaming Expo. Until next time, see you on the flip side.